So now we'll add the mouthpiece to the buzz that you've been working on. It's basically the same thing. You're just going to put the mouthpiece over the buzz. Again, you want the corners here tight and looser in the middle. And the aperture, you want to know where your aperture is in your buzz. So buzz your lips, and you're going to put your hand over your lips to feel where that air is coming out. So for example, I'll do my buzz and feel where the air is. It's coming out right there. And you might notice that my aperture is a little bit off center. That's okay. It doesn't really matter. As long as it's not way over here or way over here, as long as it's more or less in the middle, you should be okay. When you place the mouthpiece on your mouth, you want half of the mouthpiece on your upper lip and half on the lower lip, so it should be centered. And you're going to want to put that little circle right there in the middle of your mouthpiece right on the aperture, wherever that aperture is for your mouth. And when you hold the mouthpiece, you're going to hold it by the shank towards the end, like this. And that is to help you reduce using pressure on your embouchure. You only want enough pressure to seal the mouthpiece on your lips so that you're not spraying spit all over the place and air. But not much more pressure than that. Just enough pressure to get a good seal, and that's all you need. So, without further ado, I'm going to do my buzz, and I'll just put the mouthpiece right over the aperture. You may need to move the mouthpiece around a little bit to find the right spot. And again, you're looking for a fat, warm tone and steady. So, here we go. So again, your buzz might be lower, it might be higher. Again, you want to do it for as long as you can. You may have noticed that I licked my lips before I placed the mouthpiece on my embouchure. I use what's called a wet embouchure. There's also the possibility of using a dry embouchure, which means you don't lick your lips. So try both of them, see which one you prefer. Some use one, some use the other. Most people use the wet embouchure. But give that a try. There are a whole bunch of exercises in All About Trumpet for buzzing with the mouthpiece. If you spend 4 or 5 minutes a day buzzing with the mouthpiece, you will improve almost every aspect of your playing: tone, range, endurance, all of those things. It's also a great way to warm up, so make sure you do lots of buzzing with your mouthpiece and you won't regret it. Good luck.